server space. And so they told me, so I had an issue yesterday with one of my sites, and they said they have to look, I have to escalate it, look into it and see what the problem is. And so I looked into it, and it was they said that the issue was caused by a virus, and I needed to check my email, my emails, and check my computers and everything else for viruses. So I have a Mac. I've had Macs since I was, well, since 2000. I've had Macs for 13 years. I've been using them exclusively for 13 years. And I have never had a virus, literally never had a virus until recently, until now, really, this last year, I guess. And the reason is because before, Macs were really off the radar for most hackers and people trying to send out viruses and stuff, because most people targeted PCs. But the prominence of Macs now and the growing popularity has put them on the radar. And so now people are beginning to attack Macs, just like they attacked PCs. People always said, you know, well, Macs don't get viruses. Well, they can get viruses. It's not that they couldn't get them, it's just they were rarely targeted for viruses. So anyway, so I did this, I downloaded a virus, Norton virus or whatever thing, Norton or McAfee, it was Norton, I think. Anyway, I downloaded it and put it on my computer, one of my laptop, my other computers, and my main computer had over 100 viruses on it. It was 100 something viruses. I was like, fuck. And they were like backdoor viruses where somebody can come backdoor and get through without you ever knowing it and having access to your computer and your financial information, your username, all that kind of stuff. So, plus I didn't have my firewall turned on, which I have turned on now, which was stupid. But anyway, so I got that taken care of. Hopefully that's going to fix it. I have to delete them all and everything and it'll be okay. What I want to talk about mainly, though, before I get on the other stuff, the fun stuff, is I want to talk quickly about cyber harassment and trolls. Because, you know, I've been a user of the internet, as I said before, since I was 14 years old. And, well, even before, I think I was, well, yeah, the internet since I was 14 years old, computers since I was 5. But 14 years old, I've been using computers over the internet. And, you know, there's always been trolls on the internet, even in the beginning of time. So, you know, I remember when I was on Prodigy or AOL or whatever, in the very beginning of the internet age, when I would encounter people who were quote unquote trolls. And so what is a troll technically? Well, this is what it defines as troll is this. In internet slang, a troll is a person who sows discord on the internet by starting arguments or upsetting people, by posting inflammatory, extraneous, or off-topic messages in an online community such as a forum or a chat room or blog, either accidentally or with the deliberate intent of provoking readers into an emotional response or of otherwise disrupting normal on-topic discussions. So I'm sure those of you who have been around the internet, especially if you've been on Blog Talk Radio, or you've been on even Spreaker, or you've been on Twitter, or you've been on Facebook or whatever, into chat rooms or forums, you've encountered trolls. I am so sure you have. And to me, they just are really the lowest of the low, the lowest, you know, the scum of the earth kind of people. And I have a lot of experience, unfortunately, with them and trying to, you know, get a rise out of me or whatever. And what I did on my show essentially was just, when I had my show on BTR, was just ignore them. And I would always just boot them out and just, you know, completely not entertain them in any fashion whatsoever, whether it was on the phone or whether it was in the chat room. And so I haven't had any issues on Spreaker yet at all. So fortunately, that hasn't been the case here at all. So hopefully I won't have an issue with them. But I think the people who are trolls and do it deliberately and really have a desire to just, you know, hurt people or to cause discord, really have, I don't know, a chromosome missing or something. I mean, seriously, I don't understand people who do things like that just to hurt people. But unfortunately, the internet is full of them and it's part of the gig. So if you're on the internet, especially if you're communicating on the internet, you're going to encounter them. And so the best way to deal with a troll is to just ignore them and they will eventually go away. And that reminds me of cyber harassment. I wanted to talk about that because cyber harassment is, you know, basically harassing people over the internet. There's a lot of hosts on Blog Talk Radio, hosts on TalkShoe, hosts on I host on here as well. On Spreaker that I've seen a few, but not as much, that allow people in their chat rooms to just say anything, to do whatever the fuck they want, to have horrible, horrible names and, you know, their handles or whatever they're called, you know, their names they use on the internet that have the N-word in them or that have the F word in them or whatever, or I hate faggots, or I hate N word or whatever. So, and they allow these people to stay in there and say that they're just, you know, there and they don't really agree with what they're saying, but they allow the people to spread all this hatred and this, do this, all this trolling in their chat rooms, you know? And I don't understand that. So if you're not somebody who agrees with it, if you don't agree with what they're saying, whether it's racist or whether it's homophobic or misogynistic or anti-Semitic or whatever it is, if you don't agree with it, then why do you let people stay in there in the first place? You know, that's my question. I don't understand that, because to me, it's the same as in the real world. If you surround yourself with people who are bigots and assholes and liars and harassers and homophobes, then wouldn't you also be one if those are the kind of people that you keep company with, you know? So I don't really do that. And that's why I've never done it. I've never entertained those kind of people. I've never allowed them to stay in my chat rooms or given them a voice, is the way I put it. I've never given them a voice at all or a forum to say the horrible things that they want to say, at least not on my show, because I think they have plenty of opportunities to say it, you know, elsewhere. And I'm certainly not going to allow them to do that on my platform. So to me, if you stand by and allow that to happen, you are complicit and you are part of the problem. So I'm, you know, and there's plenty of trolls that we all know of, from BTR, which I'm trying to escape here on Spreaker. And I've had an issue, fortunately, here, and I've ignored them. And finally they're not coming after me anymore. And hopefully that's the way it will stay. So we shall see what happens ultimately in that arena, but I don't know if it's going to change or not. I just hope that what I really want to do, and what I've always wanted to do on my show, is just have a good time and talk to people and just, you know, have conversations about topics that I like to talk about and not be bothered by all the nonsense that goes on other shows. Because to me, it does affect you, and people often say, oh, just ignore it or whatever. And yeah, the things people say are minor to some degree, but as a whole, as a collective whole, when that's a continual barrage of horrible things being said to you over and over and over and over and over and over again, and a variety of things, then it becomes difficult. So anyway, what the hell happened there? Something happened. Somebody called, but they hung up. Anyway, so to me, it's definitely a different... it's something I hopefully will change in people. So I guess what I'm asking you to do, call to action, is if you're listening to this show, is don't entertain trolls. Don't feed the trolls, as they say. Don't allow them to have power over you by engaging with them, by talking to them, by allowing them to have any kind of control over you at all. If you don't give them control or attention, they will go away. I'm going to take a quick break, come back, and we're going to talk about the Russian boycott, talk about Geminis and other signs, and also a few other things. We'll be right back.
You had many, I know you did.
Testing, 1, 2, 3. There we go. Finally. Anyway, sorry. I don't know if any of you, David, when you do your shows on here, well, you don't use the kind of setup I have. That's why. If I use the Spreaker setup, it doesn't do that delay thing. But if I use this setup, it does do the delay. So it's either use their thing or oh my God, it's annoying me. Anyway, but I at least take phone calls this way, so that's good. Anyway, so apparently, have you ever had somebody who's mad at you and you have no idea why or what the deal is? Apparently, a friend of mine thinks I'm upset with them, and I don't know why, and I'm really weird. It's really strange. But anyway, a friend of mine thinks that I'm upset with this person, and I'm not upset with this person. For some reason, they think I'm upset with them, but I'm not. And yet, they have no... they haven't approached me about it. So if you're upset with somebody or think somebody's upset with you, then by God's sakes, go to them or whatever. You know, I don't understand why people don't just talk to you about it. I mean, talk to me then. Exactly. You let people be mad. So I don't know what this person's mad at me about it and do anything to them. And we haven't had a fight or anything. So it's just all of a sudden they just kind of stopped talking to me. So it's really weird, but whatever. I mean, eventually they'll come back around if they want to, hopefully. So what was I going to talk about last? So two more things. Yeah, the Russian boycott. There's a lot, you know, if you've heard about Russia is essentially becoming like fucking Nazi Germany when Nazis were vilifying all of the Jews. And not for the same reasons, obviously, but they're on a moral basis doing that to gays in Russia now. Even Vladimir Putin is doing the same thing to the and kind of putting the word out there that the Jews are, the gays are not to be trusted. The gays are horrible, disgusting, and da da da. And he won't tolerate them. They'll be arrested. They're not safe there. I mean, several have died there as a result of this kind of witch hunt. So even the Olympics that are happening there soon are going to be tainted because there's a lot of gay people who are in the Olympics, obviously, and are going to be going there, and they're afraid for their lives to go to a country which will not protect them because they're gay, and they can't even say the fact that they're gay. They actually today had someone who from